Good evening and welcome to News Channel 8. I'm Jerome Agian in the courtyard area at Baron Spot Mall. And tonight's top stories, insurance fraud on St. Thomas, as many people were bilked out of their insurance funds right on St. Thomas. Here's News Channel 8's Lee Carl with this lead story.
To say the least, people were shocked to learn that the VI Department of Justice agents on Wednesday arrested a 53-year-old man, John Gums, who runs the John J. Gums Insurance Agency. On charges, he swindled 248 people out of nearly $200,000 for one of the largest insurance scams in the Virgin Islands. This is the way the Justice Department put it together. The Division of Banking and Insurance Examiners referred the case to the Justice Department after they saw a pattern of insurance fraud surfacing concerning Gums in a routine review at the First Insurance Agency Incorporated. Gums, a licensed insurance agent, was advised of his rights by the Superior Court on Thursday, faces charges of engaging in a criminal enterprise and grand larceny embezzlement by fiduciaries and obtaining money by false pretenses. According to the Justice Department statement, Justice contends that between January 2003 and December 2005, Gums apparently hoodwinked people into believing they had bought insurance by issuing a fake insurance identification card. As an agent licensed by the Division of Banking and Insurance under the Lieutenant Governor's Office, Gums systematically solicited and received insurance premiums from 248 customers in the Virgin Islands who sought insurance policies. However, he allegedly failed or refused to transmit the proceeds of those insurance companies that were responsible for the issuance of the policies. The Assistant Attorney General, Claude Walker, said in court Thursday, Gums operated a one-man, as he put it, criminal enterprise. Justice contends Gums customers were not covered by the insurance because Gums did not send the required payments to the insurance companies responsible for providing the coverage. At the time of Gums' arrest, police set the bail at $35,000, and the hearing of Judge James Carroll reduced the bail to $10,000. He still has to once again come before the courts again as this case begins to move out into the information regarding whether there were more people than 248 people and about more than $200,000 that apparently was involved here in the insurance scam in the Virgin Islands. In St. Thomas, Lee Carl for News Channel 8.
And in other news, the AFT president, Tyrone Molyneux, is concerned about your children's grades. Here's Wes Small.
American Federation of Teachers President Tyrone Molyneux is here with us tonight, and we're going to talk about a couple of issues. First of all, about substandard grades being given to our students. A 50% cutoff point has just been issued by Superintendent Gary Malloy for St. Croix. We'll be discussing that. Then we'll be moving and talking about a meeting held by American Federation of Teachers, and that's going to be in St. Thomas later on. Well, Tyrone, first, let's talk about this petition that has been going around to you and your constituents talking about that 50% grade issuance. What's that about?
Yeah, well, first of all, thank you again. We are forced to ask the Board of Education on their meeting this evening in St. Thomas and tomorrow to put an agenda, this issue of students being issued 50% of the grade. And so we have a petition we have circulated among our members. Say that we have been informed by Superintendent Gary Malloy that the directive has been issued stating that students are not to be given a grade below 50%. Teachers object to this policy for a number of reasons. We are not opposed to assisting students who try in good faith to demonstrate their best. However, we feel it is grossly unfair to reward the students who remains at home for more time he or she attends school, who attends school and chronically cuts classes, who attends schools and refuses to perform after all attempts are made by the teacher to help the student. Before a policy of minimum grade is put in place, the undersigned requests that these conditions are examined. The inflation of grades such as this may result in even more inflation of grades across the board. This may also result in many cases, too many inflated, undeserving grades. And so we'll be asking the Department of Education, Mr. Gary Malloy, Commissioner Dr. Terry, Virgin Islands Board of Education. As you know, the Board of Education right now, it's a lame duck since the election. The board is meeting today in St. Thomas and tomorrow in St. Thomas. And we're petitioning the board to investigate and to change this policy. We think it's grossly unfair to reward grades. What about the student who, let's say, try his best, made, let's say, a 60 or 55, came to school every day, you know, involved in tutorial, did the homework, but just couldn't grasp the concept, and for whatever reason gets a 60 or 65 or 55, you know, and his colleague sits right next to him, never came to school, never showed any effort, he gets a 50%. Something seems to be wrong. And I think they need to leave the grading to the teachers and not to the superintendent.
All right. We have that going on. Now, with all this and also the problems that we've had with the infrastructure of schools like Alfredo Andrews or John H. Woodson and so forth, where's the Commissioner of Education, Laverne Terry, during all this?
Well, you know, since the school year started, we've had a number of issues in the St. Croix district, and it seems that the commissioner's style of being director, being a director, is to let the superintendent run the school. Now, granted, in the Virgin Islands versus in the U.S. mainland, the superintendents run the school on the mainland. In the Virgin Islands, we have a different situation where, in fact, the leadership of the department rests with the commissioner. And so when you have things like 50% grades being instituted, things like programs such as intervention and enrichment, when teachers are pulled to sit all day with students for, I guess, to call it intervention and enrichment, and there's no alignment to the curriculum, there's no assessment being done, there's no report cards to address the students' performance in these enrichment intervention programs. And so I'm just saying, when these policies are put in place and the leadership is not reacting to them, we have to find out what's going on. You have bell schedules that don't make any sense. You have classes start and end in the same time. There's no, you know, what you say, no break periods in between. You know, no time to move between classes in the schedule. And we think that's not correct. The facilities, you know, we have facilities that needs to be addressed. And I know some folks will say, well, we're doing the best we can, but again, we have facilities that really need to be addressed, and we're asking the commissioner to get involved, assist the superintendent in doing his job, because we think that some of these policies and some of these practices are not in the best interest of education.
Yeah, it's interesting because News Channel 8 has been called around 5 or 6 times to the schools so far by cafeteria workers, yourself, and concerned parents and so forth, and the teachers with the sick outs, and the governor having his tours, and not once have we seen Commissioner Laverne Terry on site. And that's why the media was kind of wondering exactly what she's doing and what's going on with that. All right, well, don't forget the meeting of American Federation of Teachers that's going on in St. Thomas.
The Virgin Islands Board of Education, yes, meeting today.
Okay, the Board of Education.
In St. Thomas this Friday afternoon and Saturday morning at the Board of Education office.
And the petition is being passed around about the substandard grades that are being given out on a 50% level. That the students say that's not right. They don't think that any set level should be given on that one. So Tyrone, once again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Wes.
All right. I'm Wes Small for News Channel 8.
Stay with us on News Channel 8. We have more news after the break.